Hi everyone! Prêt-à-Porter was a fantastic game from 2010, all about the world of fashion and kind of the business behind it, trying to make the most money really, as well as prestige through worker placement and getting buildings, employees, and going to fashion shows and trying to please their various criteria the most. It worked very well. It was a great game that since learned over the years that it was considered that it suffered because of its theme, and that was one of the things that made me pick it up in the first place. And since then, thanks to Kickstarter and, you know, just renewed interest from people that are like, well, I would buy this game now, that I don't mind a fashion theme, apparently that held it back at the time, we have this beautiful, beautiful version. No offense to the second edition, but wow, the third edition is absolutely gorgeous. Gameplay has been tweaked, a little bit tightened up, refreshed. The graphic design and the art has been completely overhauled. Because, yeah, it was a little bit harder to get to grips with the second edition, although it worked very, very well, if that's what you're considering getting. So, the worker placements. What can you say about worker placement? It's great. And it's that style where, you know, everybody places their worker and we go through the locations in a certain order. It's great for this combination of stuff that comes out based on not the cards that come out, because the same cards are going to come out every game, but the order that they come out can really affect things. Especially say, you know, you go to a location first, so you're going to get the first choice of the buildings, but, oh, I've picked up a contract that lets me go there before anybody else. And so you can swoop in and mess about with that way. You know, you need to get the right materials to be able to do your collection. Maybe you're doing a great big collection, but you're restricted in lots of different ways that, you know, in this place, I can buy as much material as I want, but only one color. So maybe I want to buy certain designs that all share a color so I can get those out easily. But it's not that simple, because then to be able to exhibit them, they all have to come from the same style. And I want them to be the type of clothing that my company's really good at. So I get all of these extra trend points. And, you know, maybe this this exhibition that's coming up really, really cares about trend points. So that's a really important factor for me. The other material place, I can buy only one material, but of every color. So maybe I want to diversify and get all of that, but then all of the material's more expensive, but I'll get more quality by going over here. There's all sorts of little things tugging you in different directions, and it's up to you to try and navigate through all of this stuff to try and ultimately make the most money. But I really love that, you know, it's all about, you know, getting these designs and making these clothes, but not necessarily. That can be your whole thing. That can be your entire game. You can get cards that just boost that, cards that let you go to the material places without having to spend a worker, cards that get you discounts at the material places, let you draw more designs when you go there, that let you turn designs into other styles, so you'll be able to exhibit cards that perhaps didn't fit into your plan. You can change the type that they are, so now that they do fit in with that, that can be your entire strategy if you like. Or your strategy can be almost non-existent with the fashion, and you can just go for the business side of stuff. You can hire accountants that will negate your upkeep costs. You can get retail stores and all sorts of employees that help with your PR. That's, you know, it's just as thematic as just making the dresses and things themselves. It's just as thematic that, you know, I'm just showing off one thing here, but I've got such a massive amount of word of mouth around it that at this particular exhibition, I came out with just as much prestige as the people that were just exhibiting tons of, you know, stuff that people weren't really that bothered about. I love the way that that can go down. And that's just picking two extremes, as I did in the playthrough that I did. But yeah, in the actual game, it's obviously not as polar as that. You are, you know, mixing the two strategies usually to as best you can based on what comes out, what the other players are doing. Do you need to stop them from building up this engine? You can see the writing on the wall that they've already got two accountants and you don't want to let them have another one. Is there a third one? I can't remember. But yeah, that's all a part of it, and it works together really, really beautifully. It's it does require a lot of planning. You can end up really messing yourself up if you don't have the right amount of money, and you have to take kind of punishment loans that you will have to pay back more at the end. If it can be a game where, especially in lower player counts, where there aren't going to be as many cards taken, but you know the same amount of cards are on display, and so if one player can manage to get I'm sure there are more in there that we haven't seen, and that's, you know, the depth of strategy is probably to experience players a lot more rich, and that these obvious things of, like I did in the playthrough, get the retail stores, get the cards that reward you for having retail stores, get the cards that give you more ribbons that you will get more money for, that kind of engine can be easier to get to in a game with fewer players, because you know you'll probably be going down just two different paths, whereas if there are four players, for example, you'll probably be mixing and matching more, and it won't be as easy to get those same things in there. But having said that, it's still great at just two players. I'll say that, but for all my kind of excitement about those ways that can go down, I'll say that just as a kind of counterpoint, just kind of the opposite point, that Rachel, that I play all of my games with, absolutely loved the idea of getting in a game that was, you know, fashion and getting dresses and stuff. And when it came down to it, the fact that you can kind of skirt around a lot of that, not entirely, because you do have to be exhibiting something in the exhibition to be eligible for anything, but you can kind of go there, and what I tend to do, what I kind of like doing, is you can kind of skirt around the exhibitions and stuff and just really try and get the business side of things going and not really have to worry about a lot of the materials and planning and stuff. And yeah, for her, that's really spoils the game. So it's kind of depends where your priorities lie. If you like that, the way that the game can kind of your strategy is kind of wide open to navigate these kind of opposites of the fashion and the business side of it, then that's going to be a great plus, like it is for me. But yeah, something just personal to her tastes and what she wanted from the theme, she's disappointed that ultimately, maybe she's just hoping that it was going to be this kind of fashion theme game, and that really the fashion theme thing, and that's why the theme really should never have held it back, because it's not entirely a part of the game that it's just about these dressing things. And even if it was, that shouldn't hold you back. Why does it matter? I don't care about cars, and I really love Kanban. I'm not an animal, and I like Dale of Merchants. I don't know. Yeah, it just makes no sense that you would be completely put off by an innocent theme anyway, just because you don't like dresses and things. It doesn't make any sense. But yeah, that could be, in particularly, maybe it's just a case for us in particular, but yeah, it ended up being a problem for Rach, and yeah, it's that's not one of the things that's changed in the third edition. It's it's refined a lot of stuff. It's made it eye-poppingly beautiful, but yeah, that fundamental thing for Rach in particular, maybe it's still a problem for. But I think it's a fantastic overhaul. It's great to reintroduce the game when a lot more people, you know, regardless of their taste and stuff, there are just a lot more people playing games than there were, you know, 10 years ago. And so a lot more eyes on this. And Portal, I don't know, I wasn't playing board games in 2010, but I would imagine Portal, a much more prominent company. Great big, huge booth at Essen, all with Prêt-à-Porter stuff all over it. There are probably a lot more eyes on the game now. And so hopefully, it had a great big Kickstarter campaign, so it's got a lot of people interested from there. But hopefully just from the conventions and from it being in shops and stuff, it does very well too, because it definitely deserves it. But the playthrough will give you the best idea rather than anything I've got to say about it. I'm going to go and make another one of those now. Bye, everyone.